All right, so I will get the webinar started. So welcome everyone to the ninth Startup Masterclass on public and private funding instruments and how they're explained. So I'm Florentina Smith from the Copernicus Accelerator team. And with me today, we have Zana Smilka from Fahat, which is implementing the Copernicus Incubation Program. Together with us is Gabriela Mara from the European Commission to talk more about the European Innovation Council Accelerator.
And hello.
Hi. And Niels Aldering from the European Space Agency to talk about the ESA business applications. So we'll jump straight into the presentation from Zana on the Copernicus Incubation Program.
Okay, thank you, Florentina, for the introduction, and good afternoon, everyone on the other side of the screens, and thank you for joining this session and my presentation. Really happy to have a chance to give you an insight and overview what this program can offer to you. Some of you might have seen me or might have heard me before in the previous events or webinars of the Accelerator explaining the program, but it's always good to hear the repetition and get prepared for the next deadline that is approaching quite soon. In fact, in 1 month and a half, we have the next deadline. So it's perfect timing for everyone to start writing the application. That is not that complex, but I'll explain all about it in a few minutes. So, from the beginning, the program is open since the beginning of 2018, and it can offer to startups and to the teams of entrepreneurs just like you, 15,000 euros funding, which is an equity-free funding to support your first journey, first steps in business. Very interesting, since it's equity-free, so it's public money. It's a program run by the European Commission. And we give out in total 3 million euros, 50k per startup. So 60 startups get supported within this program. We accept applications continuously. Obviously, we have some cutoff periods when we evaluate all the applications and startups and select the winners. So far, we've had 5 rounds, and we have selected 37 winners from countries all over Europe. And I have to say that the chances to get the funding within this program are quite reasonable. If I look at all my application pools from round one and other rounds, so maximum we get a little bit over 50 applications per round, and it can drop to 25, and then it goes up again. Obviously, it's changing every round, but if you look on average, then 1 out of 4 startups applying every round has a chance to get the funding. And there are different kind of industries. If you look at some statistics you can see in the graph, it's 20 different countries and a lot of different industries. The most popular industry is agriculture. We get around 25-30% applications from this industry. Here you see on the background some of the winners that have already won the grant and are incubated in the program. See different industries, different maturities. In fact, it doesn't really matter whether you are a team of entrepreneurs and you have defined your business proposition during this accelerator program, you just want building and developing your service, you can apply for this program. You might also be a startup that is up and running for 3-4 years, and you just want to add another feature, another service to your existing platform, even then you're eligible for this program. And we still have 23 vouchers to give out. Another 3 rounds, we are going to run this program. 3 preconditions, quite simple. You need to put Copernicus data and services in the core of your proposition. I don't think that's a challenge in your case. That should be a precondition you had already in the accelerator program. The second one, we are looking and searching for the strongest and commercially attractive business propositions, innovative and potential. It is quite straightforward. So maximum 50,000 euros. We cover 85% of the costs of that project that you put forward to this program. 15% has to come from another source. We are very flexible. What is that other source? It can be your own pocket. It can be your friends, family, or fools, as they say. It can also be your business angel. It can be a venture capital. It can even be another public program, another funding scheme. And we do give 50% pre-financing right after signing the contract, and the rest is at the end of the program when you submit your final report. We have done quite some effort to make this program rapid and easy to apply and get results in a very short period of time. We say after the deadline, you can expect the final result in 4 weeks. In 2 weeks, you get the result whether you are in the finals, and in another 2 weeks, you get the final result whether you can get the grant and start the process of signing the contract. We are looking at your applications in this program as investors. All our experts wear an investor hat. They look whether this is a good investment on behalf of the European Commission. So it's not a research project anymore. It's not a technology development project. It's really a business pitch you need to pitch in this program. And that's the reason why 50% of our experts that participate in the panel and evaluate the applications come from investor world, either as venture capitalists or private investors or business angels. They all have some investment background to be able to evaluate your application this lens. And you do have two opportunities to pitch and present yourself. In the first round, the experts look at your applications in the document form. We ask for some pitches, either a video or a PowerPoint, and there is some background explanation document. It's not too long. We kept it quite short so that it doesn't take too much effort and too much time to prepare, but it still has to be sharp and concise so that you have the chance to convince experts that you are the one deserving a popped in the finals. And the finals, those are live interviews with experts. You call in, you pitch your service, you pitch your business, and then you engage in a discussion together with experts answering their questions to convince them that you are one of the strongest cases. I would like to take some time to give you some tips and tricks from all the other rounds. What are the typical shortcomings? Where you should pay some extra attention if you want to get through and get a chance to win the grant. What we see that sometimes there are challenges to define the problem solution fit. So in case in your application, in your pitch, you need to describe sharply what problem do you solve, what solution from technology or service perspective you have developed, and most importantly, what's that fit? Why are you solving that problem better than all the other solutions out there? Alternative technologies, alternative services, how are you different? That's important to stress here. Another important thing is to look at the scalability. You don't need to start big. Obviously, a lot of startups start with their local environments, with their local cities, but you need to think big and aim big and present those ambitions and also very realistic, feasible plans. How are you going to get there? What's your vision? What's your roadmap? Experts always want to see some evidence, especially if you have a service in mind. Why are you confident that somebody is going to buy it? Why is somebody waiting for it? Have you talked to anyone? And the same goes with partners or any other suppliers. Any evidence will make your case stronger. It's also quite critical to present a balanced team, especially because we are talking here about investment-ready business propositions. It's not anymore only technical people that need to be in a team. You also need business people or marketing people, people who will sell and help to launch the service in market. So the more balanced the team, the stronger it is. And lastly, another tip I would like to share with you is on sales model. Usually the typical question is, where is money and how are you going to sell? How much are you going to charge and who is going to sell? which is also very important. What is your model over there? Can you answer those questions? Because eventually, as any business, you need to make money. Now, some other essentials of the program. This program requires you to apply together with a business incubator, because we are a funding scheme to support incubation in an incubator or any other support program of your choice. You don't need to sign the contract before you apply, but you need a preliminary support from them, which says that in case you win the grant in the Copernicus Incubation Program, you will be incubated in their incubator. You need that kind of support letter where they state the support, and they also provide their reasons to believe why are they convinced in your business proposition. They don't have to take any financial commitments or any other commitments, but they do have to take a commitment that they will support you in your incubation journey. So some deadlines, as I mentioned in the beginning of my presentation, we have three more rounds, three more evaluation periods we are going through until the end of 2020. And the next deadline is quite soon. It's 25th of October. So it's really, if you want to apply and you want to get a chance in this round, it's time to start to prepare your application. Not that it takes time, that much time to write, but if you need a partner, if you need an incubator or accelerator that will support your application, that's important to start to arrange that on time, because we know that sometimes those kind of things don't work out in the last week. And this is a part of the Copernicus Startup Program. Currently, you are all participating in the Copernicus Accelerator. And normally, the next logical step for you could be the Copernicus Incubation Program. Since you are more mature, you have defined your business propositions, and so to say, you're ready to start the business journey, your investment-ready business proposition. Well, that was my presentation. I welcome you to subscribe to our newsletter, to join our Twitter account, follow us on social media, approach us with any questions that you may have. And I'm really looking forward to receive your applications on 25th of October. Thank you.
Great. Thanks very much, Zana. Just to all the participants, we will answer questions at the end of the session. So in the meantime, please ask them in the Q&A box, and following the last presentation, we will come back to those. So next up, we have Gabriella from the European Commission to talk about the EIC Accelerator.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you for the invitation. It's a great pleasure to be here today with you. And I hope I can give as much information as possible about how to access EIC Accelerator funding. I'm going to also share you at it, my presentation. Okay. Oh, yeah. So my name is Gabriela Mara, so, and I am working for EASME in the evaluation team, so for the EIC Accelerator. And yeah, the SME Instrument Program is a program that has been in action since 2014. And it is intended exclusively for the small and medium-sized enterprises in the European Union and in the associated countries to Horizon 2020. In the beginning of June 2019, SM Instrument became EIC Accelerator. And of course, it is part of the European Innovation Council, which is the one-stop shop for innovation of the European Commission. Before, there were several instruments. Now you can go to the EIC website and you will be directed to the program that suits you. So the calls are always open and are bottom up without topics. There are now, of course, interviews to ensure that candidates are suitable and also motivated instead of only good at paperwork. So DIC provides agile funding to ensure a more flexible and proactive approach needed for high-risk projects and fast-moving technologies and markets, so that fundamental science can be quickly transformed into products with the Pathfinder grants, which are up to 3 million euros, and also support to innovators to reach new levels of ambitions with the accelerator. So the DIC Accelerator, the SME instrument, supports high risk, high potential SMEs and innovators to help them develop and bring onto the market new innovative products, services, and business models that could drive economic growth. And the novelties of the EIC Accelerator is the blended finance. So starting the October cutoff 2019, companies will have the possibility to ask up to 2.5 million in grants, plus up to 15 million in equity. This is a very good opportunity for the companies when the market response is absent or insufficient. So furthermore, the EIC Accelerator is for innovative startups and SMEs with the potential to scale up. The aim is to connect the to EU wider ecosystems and to promote co-investments. Therefore, the products or services must be TRL 6 or above, from early commercial to market deployment and scale up. The EIC Accelerator's main goal is to bridge the financing gap, to boost the very best innovations in Europe, and support their commercialization between late stage innovation activities and the market take up. So the EIC Accelerator pilot supports high risk, high potential SMEs looking for substantial funding to develop and bring to market groundbreaking concepts that could shape new markets, but also disrupt the existing ones in Europe and worldwide. Eligible applicants are for-profit SMEs, including young companies and startups from any sector. As I said before, in addition to the grant, the new program brings the equity part. So the companies will have the possibility to apply for grant for the activities related to the development of the product or services between TRL 6 and TRL 8, and for equity for mature innovation activities and scale up above TRL 8. The assessment of TRL or equivalent for non-technological innovation will be performed by experts during the two steps of the evaluation process. It should be noted also that there is flexibility to obtain equity, even if not requested at the moment of submission, in case that there are any mature innovation activities and the company has given the consent to receive a counter offer. In the case that the company did not give the consent, the proposal may be considered for grant funding, but the potential grant will be reduced and the proposal must contain also the information about how activities of TRL 9 are going to be funded. In regard to the evaluation, the award criteria are the same as they have been until now. So the three main evaluation criteria are impact, excellence, and quality and efficiency of implementation. The weighting is 1/3 for each criteria. The evaluation is conducted by a long and diverse list of experts that we have selected from different thematic areas and strong business and market experience. And this conducted in two steps. So the first step is the remote evaluation, and the second step is the face-to-face interviews. There are three possible outcomes after the face-to-face interviews. So go decision, no go decision, and change into blended finance decision. The process is fast, is simple, and is transparent. So the participation is very easy to be done via the online system. It takes around 6 weeks to receive the results from the first evaluation step, and then around 6 weeks to, from the second step, which are the interviews conducted in Brussels with the jury panel. After the information letter, in case that there is a positive decision for financing, the grant will be signed after 2 or 3 months. And in parallel, a due diligence will be started if the company applied for the blended finance. The three evaluation criteria apply for the interviews as well, and the leveraging of investment and scale-up potential are two aspects that are going to be assessed from now on, in addition to the sub-criteria that were assessed until now in the interviews, and you can see them on the screen. There is only one application for the two options, with the possibility to choose only for grant and also for the blended finance. So applicants positively evaluated for blended finance may be asked also to provide additional information on their equity request, of course, for the due diligence procedure. There are two new documents to be provided in addition in the application forms from now on, and these are the financial elements. So a document where the companies will have to provide the financial elements, and another document is the pitch deck, will be provided from the application, from the moment of application, and it cannot be changed before the step two, before the interviews. In regard to the blended finance, so the special purpose vehicle, the SPV, complements the EU agencies managing EAC grant funding. So the SPV set up the structure and manage the equity investment, and also has the role to attract co-investors. And of course, the SPV conducts this due diligence procedure. There will be a separate agreement for the equity investment. So the EAC funds, or the SPV, will be seeking stakes between 10% and 25% of the voting rights, but it is important to avoid counterproductive founders dilution, except in situation where strategic interests of the European Union are considered at stake, and the EIC fund will possibly acquire a blocking minority. But the EIC will not interfere with the management of the company beyond the required measures. If the consent of the company is received, the SPV will actively seek private investors to buy the EC shares. So how to apply for funding? You only have to fill in the application form through the participant portal. You can see the link on the screen, so the funding and tenders website. And of course, you have all the application forms there and all the information. And you attach your pitch deck, the PowerPoint presentation, which will be used during the step two, the interviews. And as I said before, to provide additional financial information. And there are 5 cutoffs available until the end of the program, the end of 2020. The first one is the 9th of October, 2019, and 4 cutoff dates next year. In addition to the funding, EIC Accelerator provides also business acceleration services for our beneficiaries. And this means coaching, up to 12 days available for our companies, mentoring for the CEOs and the leaders of the companies, access to the EIC community platform, and participation to EIC networking events such as corporate days where companies meet large corporations as potential investors. If you want to find out more about our beneficiaries, you can always go on the EASME SME Instrument Data Hub. You can see the link on the screen, and you can find all the name of our beneficiaries until now. And for more help, you always have local support available. You can contact the national contact points in your countries and also the European Enterprise Network. And you can always find the information, and I have put you the links on our websites regarding all the information to prepare your applications. Thank you very much for your attention. And of course, I'm very happy to reply to your questions.
Great. Thank you very much, Gabriella. Unfortunately, Niels Aldering, who would be presenting the ESA business application, hasn't joined our webinar today. So what we'll do is we'll move straight on to the question and answer session. And we have a comment from Suvrajit regarding the support letter for the Copernicus Incubation Program. So, Zanim, perhaps you could explain a little bit more about that.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for the question. Thanks for the comment. I understand that there was unclarity. What exactly is the support letter about? There are two things I would like to comment on. First of all, this is a hard criteria that has been given to us by the European Commission, that every startup participating in this incubation program should cooperate with an existing incubator or support program anywhere in Europe to make sure that there is an institution that could support startup with services or any other support platform that startup may need to basically increase the support provided by the grant. That's one thing. And the other thing, the support program can be any kind of program or platform that supports startup. I mentioned incubator, but it doesn't have to be an incubator. It can also be an accelerator program. I mean, there are all kinds of names we use these days for institutions that support startups in their first stages during the incubation period. So any kind of support program would qualify, but that does mean that you need to arrange your partnership or your relationship with the support program before you apply to our program. I hope that clarifies the question or the question behind the comment.
Thanks, Sana. I have a question for Gabriella from Isaac Dura. The question is the EIC Accelerator compatible with other public funding sources like Horizon 2020 Phase 1?
Horizon 2020 Phase 1, it will actually disappear. It's the last cutoff this year will be the 5th of September, so it's part of the same program. But and actually, for the companies that apply for the phase one, they can for sure apply after they have finalized their grants, because they cannot apply in the same time for phase one and phase two. And this is the rule that it has been applied until now as well. So. So this, you will have the opportunity to apply for phase one the last time on the 5th of September, which is next week.
Great, thank you. Zana, coming back to you, Suvrajit had a follow-up question. He said that it's perhaps not clear exactly what you require with the support letter. Could you elaborate on the requirements of that?
Yes, there is actually only one requirement, that there is a specific support program that you have arranged a partnership with, and that institution writes a letter saying if you get a grant, you can be incubated in their program and get a number of services available to you. And we obviously ask them to list the services that are available in their support program. And we also ask them to list some reasons why do they believe in your business proposition. And then that's basically it. And there is a letter from the institution that is a requirement to finalize your application.
Fantastic. Are there any more questions from the attendees or the participants of the webinar today? There don't seem to be, so I will thank you all very much for your attendance. If you have any follow-up questions, please feel free to contact us, and I would be more than happy to pass that information on to the appropriate person for the question. Otherwise, we wish you a fantastic upcoming weekend, and thank you very much again.